We'll be right back. And we are live from V-Town. It's The Nest. I'm Grant McNew alongside Drake Toll and Connor Hudgens. No Stone Cold Steve Austin tonight. He's in Quebec, Canada.
Thank you for specifying which Quebec. I was thinking for a second there it might be the one in Greece, but no,
he's
not.
He's in Canada. Hey, the Vilonia Eagles, Drake, come in. They're going to play the Bryan Hornets, who don't have their football guys back. Right now the Bryan football team just manhandling their opponents in the playoffs. So we're going to get to see a bit of a skeleton crew for their basketball team, but still a good team nonetheless. They're a well-coached team. They're 2 years removed from a state title appearance, so you've got to be ready if you're the Vilonia Eagles.
Yeah, it looks like Bryant at this point in the season is not counting any of the games they're playing until their football guys are back. So if you look at a lot of websites, you go out there and study Bryant basketball, you'll see that they're 0-0, which is not right.
You can't study them.
It's not really indicative of what Bryant actually is. They've been playing games, but without those football guys, you're not seeing the Bryant you would see, you know, 4 or 5 weeks from now, or even going into 2022. But still, you said it. It's Bryant. The name
it's
follows
Bryant.
With it. The athletes follow with it. The coaching follows with it. This is still the Bryant Hornets.
And speaking of the name following with it, this is what we do know based on what research we're able to do. You've got Cason Robinson, number 11 on the Bryant squad. He was hurt for all of last season, Drake. He didn't get to see the court much at all until injury hit him. Little brother of K.K. Robinson. A lot of people know him, a Razorback basketball player. Not the same level of athlete, how recruiting-wise. But you got to expect him to come out and be a baller, as the kids are saying.
Yeah, I mean, you know, if you got a guy who's – it's the older brother syndrome, right? The little brother always – you get beat up out in the yard and out on the blacktop. And so now you got something to prove this season here at Bryant for Cason Robinson. So I expect him to come out and show something today and the rest of the year. You get that chip on your shoulders. Everybody keeps comparing me to my brother, saying I'm not as good.
Yes.
I mean, this guy wants to prove that he is his own player. That's usually how that goes for your TJ Watt types.
Right, and for this being his senior season, this is the year that he's got to do it. So he's going to be a weapons, Drake.
Yeah, I mean, look out for him, but on the other side, you know, Vilonia's got their fair share of weapons. You're looking at guys like, obviously, you know, I am partial to Deshaun Spence.
He will not be starting tonight, by the way, coming off of the bench. That's big news. I know that breaks your heart, Drake.
It does.
I know it does, but we will still be seeing him off the bench.
The guy's pretty good at basketball, so I've heard. You know, his first time ever playing organized basketball was in the Pee Wee ranks here at Vilonia, and there was some random high schooler who was his head coach, taught him how to windmill dunk, something.
Was it Chase Lewis?
Take Droll out of his one of those things like that. I don't remember, but I just know that he was really good in Pee Wee basketball. I think it's the last time I got to watch him in person. So excited to see him play today. And this Eagles squad as a whole that put it on BB. I mean, in your first action, you got a new head coach in Troy Campbell.
Yes.
And, I mean, he has solidified himself as somebody that could make waves in the 5A.
You know, you're exactly right. And we got to see that first game here in the Nest for Coach Campbell. His first time as a head coach for the Vilonia Eagles. And he was nervous, Drake. I don't know if you got to see even the post-game interview with him. He was shaking and asked him, what does it feel like to finally get that first one? And he said, man, I am relieved. It's finally done. I got it. But, you know, looking at that BB game, the Eagles, they allowed 0 points in the entire third quarter. Just absolutely unheard of. And it came off the back of Jaquel Lovelace, who stepped in off the bench, like we'll see Spence tonight. And he made an impact defensively, and that spurred the offense.
Yeah, 0 points. Is that good?
That's pretty good.
It's pretty good. And I want to see tonight the pace of play be a little bit more up-tempo for Vilonia. You
up-tempo.
Saw only 47 points in that BB game, but a lot of that is attributed to how BB plays. They only scored 22. I mean, BB's okay with that. Look, it's the old Coach Davis days here at Vilonia. We might only score 36 points, but if you score 35, I'm fine with that. I want to see tonight Troy Campbell, these Eagles, pick up that pace and dictate it.
Hey, we've got a quick commercial from Linda Maries, and then we'll be right back for the opening lineups.
Linda Maries, your one-stop shop for fabric, makeup, jewelry, fall decor, and more. Located on Highway 64 in the Vilonia Commons, Linda Maries is a hidden gem and a staple of the Vilonia community. Linda Maries is always showcasing seasonal deals and special offers, so come check them out today. Linda Maries, a proud sponsor of Vilonia Eagle Vision and Vilonia Athletics. Duckhead, Lucky Brand, Oxford, Hey Dude, and more. Charlie's Corner is your one-stop shop for all your manly apparel needs. Don't forget to check out their sock collection and Razorback apparel when you stop by. Charlie's Corner, a proud supporter of of Ohlone Eagle Athletics.
Thank you for your business.
D&N Construction has been a proud supporter of the Vilonia Eagles as a locally owned and operated business since 2011. For any commercial, residential, and remodeling needs, be sure to call D&N Construction at 501-796-6316. And, as always, go Eagles!
Back here for the from both squads. First out will be the Bryant Hornets as they are the visiting team. Their first name is going to be number 15, who is not on the roster. This could get interesting.
That was quick.
This could get interesting. Now number 25, Darren Wallace. He is followed by 24, Gabe George. Number 12 on the roster is Landon Newburn, and last out of the shoot is going to be number 11, Kaysen Robinson, the senior guard.
It's basically a pick and guess, right?
Yeah, exactly.
When the number's not there, you're just kind of –
I like to name the players, Drake.
Shoot for something. That could be interesting.
Now for the Vilonia Eagles, we will not be getting the light show, but Jones Wyatt will step out as the first out of the gate. For the Vilonia Eagles, junior guard Jones White. Next out is going to be the sophomore guard. That's Josh Lawrence, showcasing some incredible athleticism. Next out is going to be number 22. That is Cannon Bartlett. Following Bartlett is going to be number 21, the junior Cade Smithart. And he is known for getting in people's heads, Drake.
Yeah.
Last out of the gate is going to be number 30, Aaron Brown. Not the usual Deshaun Spence that we like to see, but Aaron Brown, boy, can he step up big.
Yeah, there you go. You're going to have to see that today in this Eagles starting five. You want to start fast, and you really want to show Bryant, hey, I don't care if you got your football guys or not. I mean, we're going to control this game, play our brand of basketball, and pick up a big win today. Grant, if you're narrowing it down to for Vilonia, I mean, who are you looking to out of this starting five that's got to step up and really play well for the Eagles to win?
Out of the starting five, I think you've got to look at Jones White. We saw some big performances from him a year ago, especially against Nick Smith and Sylvan Hills when they came away with a big win there. Jones White can really step up big time, and when he does, it's great for the Eagles.
Aaron Brown, man, you got to use that big, tall, 6'6" frame in this game.
And he's not afraid to use it either. You'll see him up high, posting up high rather in the post, or even behind three-point line. As that tip goes to Bryant, quick 2 points with a missed dunk, rebound Lawrence.
About that, Bryant really showing they want to go fast. This is not BB. Close to BB. You're going to get some high-caliber basketball today from both these squads.
Smithart finds Lawrence top of the key. Now it's Cannon Bartlett, one of the better guys in the state for football is Cannon Bartlett.
Yeah, Cannon Bartlett stepping up big here in basketball. It's a very different game. I mean, it's a different style in general.
Yes.
Obviously, you know, basketball and football.
Lawrence driving along the baseline, spins around, loses the ball. It's going to go out of bounds. Last touch by the Bryant Hornets. Yes, to add on to Cannon Bartlett, you're making the transition over to basketball. He actually now holds the receiving record for yards for the Vilonia Eagles.
Wow. Yeah, I mean, you go from that. I mean, look at basketball players in college, and it's complete different weight training. It's everything you do. You know, you want to shave pounds for basketball, gain pounds for football. That transition's tough, especially when you have such a high-caliber football team here that puts those guys in football shape.
Jones-White for Valonia. He's going to kick it out near side corner. Lawrence finds the baseline. Double clutch up. No good. Rebound number 15, not on the roster. But there's some people to ask right here what his name is. I'm sure we'll find out.
Yeah. If I'm Lawrence right there, I want to embrace contact early. Put a body into a defender. Go up. Get fouled right there. Show that I'm not afraid to go in the defender, not around one.
Robinson going to work against Lawrence. Pull up from deep. Rims out. Rebound. Jones-White.
Man, Bryant is really, really close to being up 5-0 right here. Eagle defense got to take advantage of that.
Brown. Kick out. That's Cannon Bartlett now. Bartlett going to give it away to Smithart on the far side wing. Great defense from Bryant to step out.
Yeah, about this Bryant D. The man-to-man, and they are just in a really great spacing on both ends, but that middle's open.
Jones-White wanted to pull up. He got it shut down. Now it's Aaron Brown with it.
Man, I would not be surprised at the next break to see Coach Campbell go with a high post. Bring somebody in that middle spot, because you can see that still the middle is wide open.
Jones-White from mid-range, no good. Rebound just too long for Aaron Brown to get to. Now it's number 12, Landon Newburn. Newburn, Euro step, going to throw it up. No, but a foul is called. He's headed to the line to shoot two.
Hey, Josh Lawrence is a young guy right there, and it comes with experience, but set up for the charge. Show a charge deep on the floor, too. Even if you don't get it or if it's a block call, show that charge, and it's going to defer the guy with the basketball. Deter. That's what we're looking
for. Deter. There you go. First free throw up and no good. Several opportunities to score for Bryant, and they just haven't been able to come away with points.
Yeah, still nobody has scored. We're 2 minutes and 3 seconds into this game.
Landon Newburn. His second free throw will go. It's 1-0. And Drake, if it ended like that, that would be scorigami.
What are the odds the score holds? Probably zero.
Probably zero.
Man, this game for me out of the starting five, it comes down to Jones-White. It really comes down to Jones-White and how well he's able to dictate pace for the Eagles, control the basketball, and keep this squad from turning the ball over. He's got to be a floor general today, especially with a couple of younger guys on the floor.
Bartlett, he's going to pull up mid-range, and he gets it to go. 2-1, Eagles take the lead here in the Eagles' nest.
I mean, that shot looked like mid-season form, huh? Welcome back.
Welcome back. Gabe George at the logo, going to give it up to Robinson, right back to George. 25, Darren Wallace. Go ahead, Drake.
Eagle defense, good spacing here.
That pass wide open in the middle of the lane. That was number 12, Landon Newburn, got it to go. The only Brian Hornet with points is Newburn. He's got three.
Cason Robinson set that play up, too. He drug three defenders toward him, new to dish the basketball. Just a smart play by Cason Robinson. An assist is as good as a score.
Jones-White. They get the screen from Brown. Aaron Brown is going to try to roll away from it. Miscommunication.
Great shot fake.
Looking for Bartlett. Couldn't get the pass to him. It's going to go out of bounds. Turnover.
How about this? Deshaun Spence. I hear he's pretty good.
Yes, Deshaun Spence is going to check in, but also Jaquel Lovelace really got the Eagles going against the BB Badgers. Maybe he can do that here.
Yeah, Deshaun Spence, I mean, you can see it in the frame. Just that he's a mountain of a man out there. And that's 6'5", but he plays taller. He's got great vertical speed, lateral speed, and the dude's just he's fun to watch.
Drake, I think you might have a man crush over there as that ball sails out of bounds. Eagles going to take over.
It starts with great peewee coaching.
Does
if you've
it?
Got a
Does
guy
it?
In youth basketball that's going to instill those intangibles in a kid like Deshaun Spence, you're in for a good one. And I think that's where a lot of this comes from.
Whatever you say, Drake. Jones-White.
Just calling
far
like
side.
It is.
Oh. Spence looking for Bartlett. Can't get it to him. Now it's Jones-White on the near side. Jones-White going to keep it himself. Far side now, handoff to Lovelace.
Eagles are still leaving the middle open. I mean, nobody down there. You got 6'6" in Brown, 6'5" in Spence. Get somebody down low.
Fast break opportunity for Robinson. He's going to drive, and they're going to call a foul against Spence.
That's a pretty easy foul call right there. They're actually going to get Jones-White with it, which I think is the right call. Spence kind of lagged behind. Look like he wanted one of those pin blocks against the backboard. That's what he was waiting for, but instead, you got a foul. Bryant goes to the line. We're 4 minutes in, only 5 combined points here. Hopefully, you took the under.
I'm not a betting man, Drake.
Well, that was a joke.
That's high school basketball. I don't believe that's legal.
It's not. That's why it was a joke.
I don't think it was very funny, Drake.
Okay. Some jokes aren't. The funniest ones are the ones you have to explain.
That's true. That's true. 2-4. Chance to make it 5. Zapri throws up and good for Cason Robinson.
Can't get complacent here if you're the Eagles on offense. Yeah, it's a tight game, still close, but you're going to have to put up points. 2 points in the first 4 minutes, not what the coach drew up on this one. you want to score on this possession.
Jones White. Give away to Cannon Bartlett. Now it's Lawrence at the logo. Lovelace, he's going to drive and put it up. It did fall, but we're going to get a foul on the floor. Rather a turnover.
Offensive foul.
Wow.
Got that one against Spence.
That's unfortunate because Lovelace just was on a mission there to the basket.
Yeah, that would have gone too. Would have been a big score right there.
Gabe George on the near side. Lovelace was out defensively. George now at the logo again. Gabe George, giveaway, right back to George.
Great rotation by the Eagle defense here too.
Billingsley can't hold on to that ball. It's going to go out of bounds. Eagles take over.
That's high hands. I mean, you might not be the biggest or the longest team in the world if you're Valonia, but if you got high hands and you just stretch yourself out, it looks like there are six, seven guys out there on defense. That's going to generate turnovers.
Lovelace finds Bartlett right back to Lovelace, who wanted to drive, and so he'll kick it back out.
Deshaun Spence in the paint right there.
Jones White with a deep three. He's going to pull up. No good. Rebound, Lawrence. He'll catch him with a positioning foul.
Yeah, he went right over. Not bad. Not bad. I like that.
And that's something we pointed out yesterday, Drake, where you – that's a bad foul to get, yes,
yeah.
But it shows the effort on the boards.
It shows that you want a rebound. It shows that you're going to do what it takes to get a board, and I like that from Josh Lawrence, the young guy. And I'll tell you what, though, the Charlie Thomas days are long gone. You know, it used to be you used to see Valonia really throwing the rock inside a lot. No big guys down low yet. I want to see that offensively.
Lovelace comes away with a steal. He was sitting in that passing lane. Mikel Lovelace going to drive, kick out to Bartlett, far side corner, head fake. Right back to Lovelace, looking for Spence, gets it to him down low. Deshaun Spence pulls up, fading away, no good. Rebound Bryant there on the move now.
It's a good shot. It's a good shot.
Newbern on the far side, and a spin, wants to drive. Bartlett pushes him back out. That's number one. He's not on the roster as that ball goes out of bounds.
Fast hands from Josh Lawrence. But, yeah, you know, Garrett Brown, Charlie Thomas, those guys, man, you look like 6'8", 6'9" out there from Bologna. I mean, that was, what, 5-6 years ago? Just pounding the rock inside, hounding teams. Jacob and Josh Berry, Austin Newell, Aaron Newell. Gosh, the throwback right here. Just being
the
in this
throwback.
Gym brings it back.
You're making me feel old over here, Drake. Rather young, actually.
You were like 4 or 5 those years, right?
Something like that.
Something like that. A little too young to go to the games. You were still living in Jonesboro, I believe.
I might have been.
Yeah.
Near side, that's number 11, Kaysen Robinson against Bartlett. He's going to drive, get it poked away by Lovelace. No one there to clean it up. Spence nearly got that block. Instead, he'll lose the rebound. Mm. Whistle blows.
Stepped out of bounds.
Going to be out on Bryant. Number 25, Darren Wallace, the last to touch it.
Yeah, take it the other way. Again, good deeds. The man defense from Valonia. You don't see that too often.
Bartlett had the chance to shoot, wasn't comfortable with it. Far side corner. We'll give it right back out to White. Riley Sather preparing to check in for Valonia. He had quite the impact offensively against BB. See if he can't get this offense going for the Eagles when he does check in.
The motion offense right here, just no holes.
Lovelace drives, puts up no good. Rebound Lawrence, who ripped it away. And a foul going to be called against the Bryant Hornets.
Yeah, you got the constant motion from the Valonia offense. The way you set that up is that at some point in time, no matter how long it takes, a defender is going to be out of position. You're going to find a shot. Right now, though, for Bryant, you can see how disciplined this team is. Nobody's out of position. I mean, they're ready for it. And on the other side, Valonia in the man-to-man, a zone defense can be complacent. It's what you do. It's the easy way to go. Valonia's playing a man-to-man, and they've only allowed 5 points in the first 6.5 minutes of this game. Is that good?
Yes, that was good. I'm just confused on what is happening. I thought it was going to be a foul on the way up. Instead, it's going to be an inbound play for Valonia.
Well, there you go.
Wow.
Guess you still put a foul on the board. One foul for both teams. That can't be right. 4 fouls for Valonia, 1 for Bryant.
White inbounds to Lawrence. They'll say he shoved his arm out. Yes, he did. That's going to be against the Eagles.
I'm not sure if he even made contact right there, but even that motion in itself can't do that. You can't do that.
Wesley McKissick going to check into the ball game. He'll add some height as Lawrence checks out, going to be coached up a little bit.
Wesley McKissick played some football, if I understand correctly.
He did. Backup quarterback actually had quite the season a couple years ago when Austin Myers had to step out.
Yeah.
Won a playoff game.
Oh,
whistle blows. That's going to be a foul.
I don't like that call at all. That's a touchy foul right there. I think Lovelace is just playing good defense. It's a loose ball right there. If the Bryan player doesn't have possession, I mean, anybody's got the rights to the basketball, that's a touchy foul. Now you're telling me it's 5-1 fouls in 6-1 on the foul board in favor of Bryan.
Lovelace pokes that ball away, couldn't save it, and he is there defensively again. That's what he's so good at, is getting the Eagles' defense rolling. Here, yes, you've only scored 2 points, Drake, in the first quarter thus far. But, Bryan, they've only got five. That's one more bucket.
How about that for Lovelace right there, too? The guy gets a foul, and then as soon as the inbound comes in, he's not afraid to play aggressive and knock that ball out of bounds.
Eagles do have 6 fouls against the team as a travel is called against number 12, Landon Newbern. They do have 6 fouls on the team, but right now for everybody on the court, no one has more than one.
Yeah.
So no real foul trouble for Valonia, just some shared fouls.
How about Bryant has 4 or 5 turnovers here, and it's just that Eagle defense suffocating right now. You can see already Coach Campbell is going to emphasize strong defense. What does defense do?
Wins championships.
Boom.
Jones-White pulls up for three, no good. A rebound, gonna go out of bounds off of number 3, who is not on the roster, but I'm assuming that's James Billingsley.
Sure. We'll
since there are two number 4s.
We'll go with that. We'll say it is. Could be Chris Ganaway, too.
It could be. You never know.
It's somebody. Somebody whose name we have.
Jones-White gets it inside to McKissick. I'll bring it back out. That Sadler is going to drive to his left side. Kick out to Jones-White in the corner. White along the baseline. He's getting away. Finds Sadler. He's going to pull up straight away for three. He got it.
Tie it up right
Riley
there.
Riley Sadler.
One
five
shot.
5-5. Big shot.
Off the bench.
Yes.
Solid.
Gabe George going to drive, put it up. He traveled on the way to the basket.
That's another touchy call right there. I don't know if I saw it exactly, but I tell you what. Hey, it's 1 o'clock on a Tuesday. These officials were drug out from their day jobs to come officiate a game at 1 o'clock on a Tuesday. They're going to blow those whistles, you know. They didn't come here for nothing.
Exactly. Hey, 30 seconds left here in the first quarter. Eagles have it tied up 5-5. Extremely low-scoring ball game this afternoon. Jones-White. Driving is going to be hacked on the way to the basket.
There you go. That one was a foul. I will give it. That one was a foul. 6-2 still on the foul count. Just the second for Bryant right now. Inbound right here. Gets away from Sadler. Still no backcourt though.
That was smart by Sadler to let it go across the line before picking it up.
Don't make a hero play.
Lovelace pulls up mid-range, no good. Rebound, still on the ground. McKissick's got it, trying to get it away, and he does get it to Spence.
6 seconds.
5 seconds now. Spence drive, kick out to McKissick, far side corner for three. Wow, my boards are gone. Spence wants to throw it up, didn't get it off in time. No foul call. 5-5 is your score at the end of one.
You smell that? You smell that? It smells like commercials.
It does. Well, we'll get some slides up there. The Diamond sponsors. Connor Hutchins doing a great job behind the camera, by the way, and the computer. He's doing two jobs, which is really incredible. You got Centennial Bank and Linda Marie's, your Diamond sponsors. Drake, you're actually closer to the computer, and I can't read that far to get all of them, and I don't want to miss out on anything.
Yeah, Platinum sponsors, Sims Electric. You have Countryside Motors, Valonia Therapy Services, HSA Engineering, Valonia Realty, and then you also have Chad Roller at Genwell.
Yes.
Yeah, Platinum sponsors continue. Valonia Funeral Home, DNN Construction, Reeds. And how about old Carter Archer at Caldwell Banker?
And Lane Family Dentistry.
And Lane Family Dentistry, with the gold sponsors being around
the table.
And Valonia Family Pharmacy.
Oh, you haven't been here in a while. There are the silver sponsors, Harp, Simple Simons, Infinity Hair, Drake, Sushok Insurance, and Ott Insurance.
Thanks.
With Luke Gordon.
It's because of the mullet. I will tell you this. Since I left, the sponsor list has gotten much more thick. At one point in time, my first year, it was Linda Maurice in basketball, and that was about it.
Oh, and those were some good days, Drake, too.
Those were the days, my friend.
Linda Maurice, she's been here from day one. An OG, if you will.
Yeah.
5-5, Eagles going to start the second quarter with the basketball.
I think Linda Marie would say she's a self-proclaimed OG. I think she would say that herself. It's probably a direct quote.
Probably.
Jones-White here. again, got to dictate it. Command that point guard position, be that floor general.
McKissick on the near side, give away to Sadler. He's pushed right back out. Ali Sadler, he's going to drive, get it inside to Spence. Power dribble up, couldn't get it to go, gets his own rebound, kick out to McKissick.
That's hops.
Would have been a tough dunk spinning back around on the opposite side. Lovelace, elbow shot up and good. Whistle going to blow. That one against Deshaun Spence. Now the shot should still count, correct?
Right, the shot will count, so it'll be 7-5. Not sure if I saw the foul there, but again, these officials have been called out to officiate a game at 1 p.m. on a Tuesday during a holiday break. They're gonna get their money's worth.
We're going to see number 11, Kaysen Robinson, at the free throw line for the Bryan Hornets. The student section is groovy, as they say. It's 80s night here in V-Town.
Yeah, they're chanting KK's better. Man, that's got to get in your head.
That's got to get in your head.
You're trying not to live in the shadow of your brother. Now the student section's taunting you with your own brother's name. Oh.
Second shot.
Clever.
Robinson.
Clever from the Valonia students, though.
That one up and good. They're going to tie the ball game at 7.
No Deshaun Spence.
Aaron Brown in the ball game for Spence. Aaron Brown grabs that pass, wants to kick it back out. They're going to say he double dribbled, and he did. Maybe better to get the double dribble rather than the stolen pass, though we saw him late. And that's a senior play, I think, to take that rather than the stolen pass.
It's impressive to me what Aaron Brown can do with his dribble. At 6'6", he doesn't play like a true post. I mean, he can stretch the ball outside, almost reminiscent of a Graham Middleton.
I thought you might say that, Drake.
I did say that.
You did.
About that, stopping the dribble, and Loveless is all over him.
That's Gabe George, no good on the three-point shot. Don't think he really hit anything, and that's why you hear the air ball chant coming from all around. Jones White loses the basketball. Now Bryant on the fast break. Gabe George up. No good on the layup. And a foul going to be called against the Eagles. I believe they'll be giving this to McKissick.
Yeah, so far in this one, as George will go to the line, Gabe George might have missed that layup without prompting from a foul. He seems like he's getting his body a little bit quicker. He's going a little bit quicker than he's comfortable with here. The Eagles are forcing that issue. So, I don't know, maybe give him a bit more space right there. It wasn't an egregious foul by any means.
George made his first one. We'll see about his second as it is up and good as well.
Pretty good form.
7-9, scoring coming a little bit more often than it did in the first.
Yeah. No kidding.
Sadler spins around, finds McKissick, right back to Sadler. Riley Sadler going to drive, floated up, and in. Just over the front end of the rim. Sadler got it to go. It's 9-9.
Yeah, Riley Sadler has 5 points. The Eagles have 9. That's good.
He came off the bench.
Over 50%.
It is.
Talk about two straight games where bench players come in and really made a difference in the offensive end. Oh, what a great play there by Sadler.
George on the drive. Free throw line jumper up. No good. Just too short. Rebound Bryant, they were able to get it away from McKissick. Now on the far side, in the corner. McKissick goes to the ground, that three-point shot up, no good, couldn't finish it. Now it's 15, not on the roster either, but Lovelace gets the steal. Jaquel Lovelace, he's gonna go up, get it ripped away, and that's a foul.
Tell you what, Lovelace stuttered right there, almost as if he was embracing contact. If you just go straight to the basket, you got a free 2 points right now. Now you gotta do it the hard way at the free throw line.
You know, but to that point, you've got a Bryan team with only 3 fouls called against them. Maybe you're trying to add to that count here if you're Lovelace as well.
I don't think that was going through Lovelace's head. I don't think he was searching for a foul, but he kind of bananaed out, led to it.
First free throw up, no good for Lovelace.
Yeah, the second free throw right here, I mean, that's it. Free throws, rebounding, it's the gritty play.
Second shot for Lovelace. That one no good. Long rebound. But it will be collected by Lovelace on the steal. Up and in.
Hey, ball doesn't lie right there.
Lovelace. Timeout called, Bryant.
Lovelace had a wide open layup. Went to the free throw line and missed two, but he got those points back from that layup that could have been wide open.
Linda Marie's, your one-stop shop for fabric, makeup, jewelry, fall decor, and more. Located on Highway 64 in the Valonia Commons, Linda Marie's is a hidden gem and a staple of the Valonia community. Linda Marie's is always showcasing seasonal deals and special offers, so come check them out today. Linda Marie's, a proud sponsor of Valonia Eagle Vision and Valonia Athletics.
Welcome back into Linda Marie's broadcast booth on Eagle Vision, 11-9 the score right now. The Eagles up on Bryant thanks to Jaquel Lovelace's layup right there. Now Bryant comes the other way after timeout. You know the emphasis is answering if you're the Hornets.
Welcome it's got to be answering. Brandy, oh, I've been here the whole time. Drake, I had to go to Waco.
Wow, you made it back quicker than I did.
I did. That's Robinson. Going to be double teamed as the drive is open. They find at the baseline 15.
Wow.
Not on the roster. Couldn't get it to fall. Rebound Lovelace.
Bryant just saw that too late. They saw it way too late. He was open there for, 3-4 seconds.
McKissick. Give away to Sadler. Jones White to Brown, far side corner.
Put the ball in Lovelace's hand. Put the ball in Sadler's hand here.
Lovelace finds Jones White on the reverse, who couldn't get it to go. A bit of a strange looking shot there. Something happened. That's going to be a charge against Robinson. Lovelace jumped in front to draw it. Wow.
This is one of my favorite calls in basketball. Man, taking charges, and a team that takes a lot of charges, it shows a lot about the culture of the team. Charge is not fun. I don't know if you've played basketball before, but when you're standing there and a guy's coming full force at you and
that's
you're just
scary.
Waiting for it, when you've got a team of guys that are willing to do that, to take a possession back, I think it shows a lot about your program. So teams that take charges, and a lot of charges, it does. It says a lot.
Jones White on the far side finds Lovelace, who's going to spin, kick it back out to White, pull up straight away for three. He got it to go.
Big shot. How about that? It's a two-possession game now. The Eagles up five. Largest lead of the game by far.
Jones White needed to get that lid off the basket for him on the night, and he finally did.
Late foul call.
Wow. Good.
I think it's the right call, but it was a late, late call, and it came from the official on the other side of the court. The near side official should be the one blowing that whistle, but I don't know if this guy near us has blown his once.
Does he have a whistle, Drake?
I'm looking now, and I think you're right. He does not. He's been using his lips. Put them together and whistling that way, and it's worked fine to this point.
Because he hasn't had to blow it.
Yep.
I really don't see a whistle around his neck, Drake.
I don't know. Maybe he's got one of those fancy ones, automated ones.
Maybe. Now free throw up and good. Front end of 1-1 will fall.
Yeah. Double bonus the rest of the way for Bryant. 4:43 to go in the second quarter. They can get their fair share of free throws right here. If that's the way they want to score, they got the opportunity here to do it.
Second free throw up, no good, left to short. Bartlett gets way up there for the rebound.
Love to see, too, Coach Troy Campbell brought Lovelace over to the sideline right beside him, and just he's right there talking to him now, coaching him up.
Jones White goes up, couldn't get the put back to go, just had to tip it away. Now Bryant on the fast break.
A lot of contact.
Looking for the baseline. Riley Sadler pushes him back out. That's going to be.
That should be a travel, and they might. Yeah.
Yes,
they
a travel.
I'm telling you what.
Wow.
These officials. They are. They're having a good time right here. They're having a good time with this game.
Oh.
That official waited until everybody in the gym was locked in and then said, all right, it's a travel.
Hey, Zam Jansky says Jaquel Lovelace is putting this Bryant offense in Jaquel jail.
Jaquel jail?
I'm glad he wasn't here to say it, but we do miss him.
What? I don't know what that. I don't even know.
Just a joke. Just a joke.
Jaquel jail means.
Oh, that's going to be a steal for number one. He's not on the roster. As Jones White got back defensively to stop it, and a foul is going to be called. I believe it's going to be against
15.
Number 15.
Yeah.
Again, not on the roster. You know, normally when it's just one kid not on the roster, we get to name them.
Right.
But I can't keep up with this many names in
half
just my
the
head.
Roster, yeah. How about that? What I love so much about that play right there for Jones White is he didn't force contact on the layup. He just really brought footsteps. And sometimes
yes.
That's all it takes. Just make that guy hear footsteps on what would be a wide-open layup, and they're going to miss it a good amount of time.
McKissick checks out. Josh Lawrence checks back in. He's got two fouls on the afternoon thus far after being coached up a little bit by Coach Campbell. We'll see what he does here. Bartlett nearly gets that one stolen away. Instead, he still finds Lawrence right back to Bartlett.
Bartlett lost the headband. That could become an issue.
You know, he did that against Beebe as well as Jones White throws it up and in.
Jones White, man. Unleashed the beast. He's now the leading scorer with 2 3-pointers in this quarter. He's got 6. Sadler's got 5. Both those guys out there right now with 11 of the Eagles' 17.
3-point shot from George, no good. Left is short. Rebound, Bryant. Put back, yes.
Yeah, Gabe George has not really been close on a couple of shots today. I think you want to force the ball into his hand, let him shoot. He had that air ball earlier, and that one missed pretty easy.
Jones White, mid-range shot, no good. Just bounces right out.
But don't send Gabe George to the free throw line. He's going to make all of them.
Is that a pre-jinx we just heard?
Yep.
Wow.
Just wait. You'll see.
Gabe George on the baseline, short corner, no good. Rebound and the putback will go for Landon Newburn.
Boards right there. I say slow it down right here. You know, Bryant's crawled back within 3. Just take your time here. Oh, there's no shot clock.
There
not yet,
not.
At least.
I think we might see it for the V-Town Showdown. And after that, I think non-conference play will be all shot clock here in Valonia.
From what I've heard, there is no power to the shot clocks here yet.
Not yet. Not yet.
Timeout is called, and oh, I see it. I see it. That's commercial.
At Valonia Funeral Home, we believe that you deserve respect, honesty, and care. With no hidden fees, Valonia Funeral Home exhibits the true nature of a family-owned and operated business. We want to offer you all the care and support you need as we help you celebrate the life of your loved one. Valonia Funeral Home, honoring each life.
And we are back here, 17-14, Eagles with the lead over the Bryan Hornets. 2 minutes, 26 seconds left in this second quarter. Drake, what do you expect to see here with the remaining time here in the first half?
Grant, you know what they call an eagle with no legs?
Ground beef.
Ground beef.
I believe that was my joke.
Nope. 2:26 to go in the second quarter. 3-point game here. Valonia with possession. Up a possession. Add to it.
Bartlett. The pass is in for Valonia. That pass nearly taken away. Jones White able to get up and contest for it. Lawrence. Working at the far side, kick back out to Sadler. Now Sadler gonna drive towards the middle, float it up. No, left it just left.
Not a bad shot there for Sadler. Eagle defense, emphasize the stop here, 2 minutes to go.
Far side, that's number one for three, and he got it to go. That's a tie ball game, 17 all. Just under 2 left to play in the first half. Lawrence, on the near side to Sadler, top of the key.
See what the Eagle offense can cook up to respond here.
Bartlett, hand off to Lawrence, who wants to drive. He's going to be pushed out, but instead he's going to spin, float it up, no good. Rebound 24, Gabe George. Now Bryan on the move. George going to drive. Euro step up, blocked by Brown. Aaron Brown sent that straight back into the face of Gabe George.
Gabe George, a great move to get to the bucket there, and then just a demoralizing rejection, and George is going to check out of the game.
That was one of those. It looked like Brown could have blocked that with his elbow.
Yeah, that's the one you think about when you're going to sleep tonight for Gabe George.
Jones White pokes that ball away.
I don't even think Jones White saw it. He just had that big wing held out.
It looked like, you know that play where you throw it off the back of him?
That's the play.
I think that's what it was supposed to be. Jones White moved the last second, though.
I want the ball in Jones White's hand right here. He's got 6 in the second quarter alone. If not Jones White, give me Sadler.
Sadler working with a screen from White. He's going to drive left side.
Good defense from Bryant. They've opened out in what looks like a 1-2-2. Maybe a little matchup zone here.
Lawrence finds Sadler on the near side. Just under a minute left to play in the first half. We're tied at 17. Jones White, kick out to Sadler. Near side wing for 3. No, there was traffic in his way. Rebound Bryan.
Tough shot.
40 seconds left. Drake, there's two very good basketball teams. Neither one completely healthy or back from football yet.
Right.
As Bartlett rips that one away down low.
There's a guy, I think his name rhymes with Austin Myers.
Yes.
Who I'm excited to see this season.
Moss Myers will be a big piece. He can score from anywhere on the floor, and that's a big part, but he's also a lockdown defender when you need him.
I've seen him nail some 75-footers.
Yes.
Ask him to do it, he'll do it.
I can't count that high.
Nope.
10 seconds left in the first half. Lawrence, top of the key, finds Bartlett. 5 seconds, Jones-White, near side corner for three. Yes, Jones-White takes the lead. 1 second left. Full court shot up, no good. Eagles walk into the halftime locker room with a 20-17 lead over the Bryan Hornets.
That's good.
That's very good.
Yeah, 20-17, I mean, that shot from Jones-White right there sets the tone going into halftime, gives you momentum. What did we see in the girls' game last night? Whoever had the momentum going into the locker room is the team that came back out firing in the second
half. Right, and as Coach Campbell said last time out, great teams win the third quarter. Right now, the Eagles, like you say, Drake, with the momentum, have quite the chance to do that. Mm.
Great teams win, you know?
Yes. Yes.
I'm glad you agreed with me right there.
I wouldn't disagree with that, that's for sure.
2017, you know, Jaquel Lovelace, Deshaun Spence, two guys that on the offensive end, you didn't see a ton of production, not as much as maybe you were expecting. But then you got a guy like Sadler, White, those two picking it back up, and you can't say enough about the Eagle defense that's held Bryant to just 17 points in the first half.
That's impressive, and that's what the Eagles, you know, we saw it against BB, Drake.
It's
this defense that steps up, gets the game going, and it sets up a win for the Eagles. Hopefully we continue that trend in the second half.
Hopefully so, and I think it starts, again, with having momentum at the end of the first half, which Valonia has, so... Give me the Eagles coming out of the third quarter starting hot. That's the emphasis today.
Absolutely. Yeah, I think we're going to take a moment
to
hear from our sponsors. I couldn't be more thankful for those guys as it is the Thanksgiving season. I almost said Thanksgiving.
It is Thanksgiving. You know what they call a turkey with no legs?
What would that be?
Ground beef.
Wow. Gobble, gobble.
Johnny and Jackie Falks own and operate Valonia Realty alongside their children with over a century of combined real estate experience. Located at 1037 Main Street across from Centennial Bank, Valonia Realty is dedicated to offering professional, knowledgeable, and confidential services to all of our clients. We are proud to partner with our community while offering full-service real estate throughout the Central Arkansas area. This includes homes, land, and commercial property. Call Jackie or Johnny, Jill Bonema, or Jared Falks at 501-796-8530.
In the community, my kids go to school here in the district, and my family also attends church in Valonia. This is my home.
At Lane Family Dentistry, we provide many services such as Botox, dermal fillers, aligners to straighten teeth, implants, tooth whitening, and smile makeovers. We also treat sleep apnea. Call Lane Family Dentistry. We are a proud supporter of the Valonia Eagles. Go Eagles!
As a Valonia alumni, I'm a proud supporter of Valonia Athletics. My name's Carter Archer, and I'm a realtor at Caldwell Banker serving Central Arkansas and surrounding areas. Growing up with a strong passion for the outdoors and realty, I fully understand the value of real estate. Standing behind honesty and hard work, I'm fully dedicated to assist you in your next investment. Go Eagles!
At Valonia Funeral Home, we believe that you deserve respect, honesty, and care. With no hidden fees, Valonia Funeral Home exhibits the true nature of a family-owned and operated business. We want to offer you all the care and support you need as we help you celebrate the life of your loved one. Valonia Funeral Home, honoring each life.
Proudly supports the Eagle student athletes. We would like to encourage all students to explore the STEM field, especially engineering, when considering a future career. Science, technology, mathematics, and even robotics are what make up the foundation of engineering, and engineering starts with education.
To reveal your property's true beauty, call Reed's Forestry Mulching and Brush Control.
D&N Construction has been a proud supporter of the Vilonia Eagles as a locally owned and operated business since 2011. For any commercial, residential, and remodeling needs, be sure to call D&N Construction at 501-796-6316. And, as always, go Eagles!
Thank you for your business.
Linda Marie's, your one-stop shop for fabric, makeup, jewelry, fall decor, and more. Located on Highway 64 in the Vilonia Commons, Linda Marie's is a hidden gem and a staple of the Vilonia community. Linda Marie's is always showcasing seasonal deals and special offers, so come check them out today. Linda Marie's, a proud sponsor of Vilonia Eagle Vision and Vilonia Athletics. It's Christmas time at Charlie's Corner. This winter, find the perfect gift with brand name options such as Duckhead, Lucky Brand, Oxford, Hey Dude, and more. Charlie's Corner is your one-stop shop for all your manly apparel needs. Don't forget to check out their sock collection and Razorback apparel when you stop by. Charlie's Corner, a proud supporter of Vilonia Eagle Athletics.
Johnny and Jackie Falks own and operate Vilonia Realty alongside their children with over a century of combined real estate experience. Located at 1037 Main Street across from Centennial Bank, Vilonia Realty is dedicated to offering professional, knowledgeable, and confidential services to all of our clients. We are proud to partner with our community while offering full-service real estate throughout the Central Arkansas area. This includes homes, land, and commercial property. Call Jackie or Johnny, Jill Bonema, or Jared Falks at 501-796-8530.
And we are back here at halftime. The Eagles with a 20-17 lead. My boy, Connor Hudgens over here to my left. Drake Toll out with his family. I think he's making his way back. But Connor, you've got an opportunity to be better than Drake. Not a lot of people get this chance. Take advantage. What do you expect to see from the Vilonia Eagles coming out of halftime?
I expect to see the same, you know, great defense we had this first half. You know, we just need to start scoring a little more. You cannot expect to win a ball game by scoring 40-ish points. You know, you have to score a lot more than that to win. We just need to be able to come out and have great offense, you know, maybe get a high post action there, get some post action. We haven't seen anything. It's been five out this so far. Probably Coach Campbell probably wanting to stretch them out, be able to drive. It just hasn't been working that great.
And, you know, Connor, that's the thing that Coach Campbell is very good at. He sets up a game plan for the first half, right, Connor? Then he sees the way that goes. Second half, he comes in with all of his adjustments. It's going to be like watching a whole new team and a whole new game plan, more than likely, as we come into the second half. So I think you're right. I think we will see a lot more post action, even when it's just driving to the basket and getting it up or throwing it up to a Deshaun Spitz, who can throw it down from just about anywhere near the basket.
You're exactly right. You know, Jones White's got 9 points. No, he's been great this first half for how much points the Eagles have, as in 20. We just need to be able to get him the ball more, because he's the only one that seems to have any rhythm in him and be able to make shots.
You know, you're right, Connor. But at the same time, this defense for Vilonia has just been amazing. You've got Jaquel Lovelace leading the charge defensively for the Eagles. Even Cannon Bartlett ripped one away from Brian Horner down low towards the basket. So it's just plays like that, that if you aren't able to get the offense going at the same level that you would want, you got to keep the defense at the same level that we saw. So you can't step back on one end to pick up from the other. You've got to maintain both sides. But we've got about a minute left. What is your final score prediction, Connor? I want to hear it.
I would say that this Eagle defense would still be playing great defense. So I'm going to say Bryant 40, Eagles 52.
Wow. Yeah. Okay, Connor, with that, we'll put you back at your job behind the computer, and we'll see what you do back there. You're doing a great job at the production manager spot. Now we're going to welcome Drake Toll back to the booth. Drake, I want to know, what's it like in Missouri? Can you tell me what it's like in Missouri?
Oh, why is my microphone wet?
I poured water on it.
I think somebody's been spitting on it or something over here.
Why are you touching your microphone? That's a little weird.
Well, Missouri is typically on the colder side, depending on where you are. There's a Branson there, which is...
Yes.
Which is, yeah. There's Columbia, Como.
Wow.
If I had to describe Missouri in a word, I would say state.
You know, that is not the answer even close to what I was looking for. I was hoping for just a simple misery.
Okay. I'm going to have to disagree with you there.
Wow.
Yeah. That's very subjective. It just kind of depends on where you are in Missouri.
Yeah, but it's in the name, right? Missouri, misery.
I don't think it is.
I think that's the joke. Listen, the funniest jokes are the ones you have to explain, okay. Drake, and that's when we had to explain, yeah. Laugh.
If you're really bad at English, then yes, maybe then. But outside of that, no. I think that was bad.
Sam Jansky's final score prediction is 45-37 as we get the second half underway.
Low scoring.
Low scoring indeed. 20-17 right now. In the post, they're going to kick it back out to Robinson for three. He got it to go right off the bat. That's what you need if you're Brian.
I think that's K.K. Robinson's brother,
it
actually.
Is.
Looks a lot like him.
Last name looks the same as well.
Ah, similar. Pronunciation's a little bit different.
Smith Hart finds Bartlett near side corner. He got it to go. 23-20 now.
We're scoring. That's 6 points in the first 30 seconds combined from these two teams. Huh. That didn't happen very much in the first half. These squads were lucky to have 6 points in the first quarter, the entire first quarter.
Yes.
Thanks.
Inside, Bartlett gets the steal down low.
We're moving.
That's what we talked about at halftime. Keep the defensive pressure up. If you're the Eagles, Bartlett does it there. Spence gets a screen. He's going to drive.
And that's not a good call. And that is not a good call. I mean, you got Coach Campbell's coaching up Deshaun here, but I don't think that's just a different level of basketball right now. And you can see the Valonia Eagle fans don't like it. I don't think I like it. You really like it?
It's hard to tell. I thought he might have set a pivot and then spun. Well,
I've been watching a lot of college and NBA here lately.
Looking at it, you know what? Actually, on the replay, you were right, Drake.
Yeah, I don't think
I was iffy on it. That right there proved your point as Lawrence nearly got the steal there. They're going to say it went out. Last touch to buy Gabe George.
Yeah, they're just not going to make a motion.
Now the referee talking to Coach Jay Moore.
Yeah.
So. Maybe a mess on the sideline there.
Yeah, a little bit of a mess.
Okay, last touch by Lawrence.
And they're going to give it to Bryant. I don't think that's right either. I think Lawrence didn't touch it last here. He just never gave a motion on where the ball was going to go.
Again, Tuesday afternoon. Now it is 1:42.
They asked those guys to take off from their regular jobs, and they said, you know what? We will. We're going to make pay for it.
Robinson up. No good. Rebound Smith Hart. And by pay for it, you mean pay their money that they get for refereeing,
yep.
Right?
That's exactly what I'm saying.
Lawrence finds Bartlett on the far side, back to the top of the key.
No, I say that in jest. These guys are doing a solid job. And it's a crew that Valonia's seen plenty of times, too. They're experienced, seasoned.
Lawrence up and in, finishing strong among the trees. Robinson trying to get the charge call. He fell a little late.
Great shot. I mean, again, that's Lawrence doing. Ooh, great
pass.
Save. Gabe George, great save. Lawrence is embracing contact there, whereas he did do that in the first half. You know, it was a talking point from Coach Campbell.
George couldn't get that to go. Hit the bottom of the rim, it looked like. Rebound Smithart, who's on the move quickly. Kate Smithart going to give to Spence. He likes to drive, and so he'll give it back out to Jones White.
We've seen George take quite a few shots. His only 2 points today came off of free throws. So, again, we force the ball into his hand and make George do something on the Bryant offensive end.
Jones White. Take it to the right side. He's going to step back. Would have been a long two instead of give it away to Lawrence.
This is a really solid Bryant team defensively.
Jones White, a deep straightaway three. No good. Rebound Spence, and he just lays it soft.
That's nice. 7-point lead. The most for the Eagles. Bryant, an emphatic timeout. They need that one. Speaking of timeout, I say we take time out of this broadcast to thank our sponsors.
To reveal your property's true beauty, call Reed's Forestry Mulching and Brush Control.
Thank you for your business.
And then I said, Steve, that's not my foot, that's a squirrel. And then he said, that's it, I quit, and he left.
Is that why he's not at the game today?
That is, actually.
Ah, wow, he left to Quebec.
He went to Quebec.
Jeez. Well, we miss Steve, we sure do. Hopefully he's out there watching. I know that he's probably on patrol or something, so he's probably paying pretty close attention to his job. But maybe he's got us on in the background. I can't help but feel bad for the guy, right?
You can't, you know, so many people mistake my feet for squirrels, but it's okay. 5 minutes, 22 seconds left here in the third. 27-20.
And squirrels. You know what they call a squirrel without legs?
What?
Ground beef.
I don't get it.
You'll get it when you're older.
Oh, okay.
5:21 on the clock here. 7-point Eagle lead. Bryant out of the timeout. They're obviously going to set up something. They need something offensively.
George. Going to kick out to the far side. That's 25, Darren Wallace. We found the baseline. They're going to blow a whistle. Looks like a foul going to be called against the Eagles. They'll give that to Cade Smith-Hart.
The whistle works.
It does. It does work.
The whistle works.
George pulls up from the elbow. Can't get it to go. Rebound would have been Lawrence, but he's fouled on the way up. And look at this, Stone Cold Steve Austin commenting from Quebec, Canada, and he says, doing great, guys. Couldn't be more happy to get that comment from Stone Cold.
Yeah.
Jones White.
Glad to know that guy's having a good time.
Jones White getting across the timeline for Valonia. Out Spence with it, he's gonna hand off to Cannon Bartlett. Now it's Lawrence near side corner, inside, he shuffled his feet, that's a travel, and he knew it immediately. Yeah. Drake, what are you doing down there?
I think it's a good call right there. If you think about it, Lawrence is a solid offensive player, thought about the shot, tries to go hezzy, and just a little bit too much movement slides that foot.
You know, Drake, we're getting a little hate for our jokes here.
Ooh.
I'm gonna say, if you don't like our jokes, find your own headset. Cade Smith-Hart to the far side. Going to drive, put it up, no. As a foul's called on the way up, Cade Smith-Hart headed to the line to shoot two.
I think it was a foul for sure. Not sure if a block is the right one to go to there. Why just picking those poor guys apart, right?
Probably. I wonder if Drake is going to make the return to the booth at some point. Talking from the heavens is what it sounded like. Smith-Hart puts his first one up. No good. Hit the front of the rim and rolled off to the side.
Don't mean to correct you, Grant, but I have sounded the same the entire broadcast.
Wow.
So, yeah.
That's a lie.
Nope.
Second shot up and good for Cade Smith-Hart. He'll go 1-for-2 on that trip to the line, 28-20.
It doesn't feel like as much as it is, but an 8-point lead. Valonia's got pretty good command of this game, especially when there have only been 48 points combined. And what is that? Control the third quarter, right? Bryant
Absolutely.
Has not scored since the first 30 seconds of this third quarter.
At the baseline, Spence goes up and sends it back.
Very athletic play against that vertical quickness. He can get up quick, block a shot like that from behind.
And he had to reach for that one too, Drake. He was pretty far back. Great job to control your body and not draw the foul.
No, true. How about those pink socks right there? Smith-Hart's got pink socks.
And a man bun.
And a turquoise-colored turquoise and white shoes.
You know, he's actually playing in tennis shoes today, Drake. And when I asked him why, he said, it just felt like it.
Okay.
That ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by number one, who's not on the roster.
Yeah,
I'm with you on that one, Drake. But, you know, going back to Cade Smith-Hart, quite the character, as they say. Not many people just decide to play in tennis shoes.
No.
And then still play well.
I'm okay with it.
Lawrence, near side wing.
Sometimes it's a mojo thing too, you know. Today I'm feeling more comfortable in tennis shoes.
Bartlett, since I went up, rebound Spence, who just puts it right back in.
Double-digit lead for the Eagles. Inside 3.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. George the ball here again. Force George to do something.
George's pass nearly taken away. Lawrence was there defensively, right back to Gabe George down the far side corner. That's number 12, Landon Newburn.
That Eagle defense, man. I mean, you're up on Bryant by 10 with a man defense. says a lot about how quick and disciplined you are. Great switch there. Brian can't even find a mismatch right here.
Three-point shot from the near side wing, and it's good for Darren Wallace, the 6'4 junior.
Wallace and Robinson have both put on a pretty solid clinic for Bryant when they've needed one.
Did you guys hear the bell for school that just rang?
That's kind of pointless, huh?
It is. Like
it's a little...
Almost sounded like a weird whistle, but instead it wasn't.
It's unneeded.
Lawrence driving, right side, put it up and in.
Sophomore.
He blew right by Gabe George.
It's a sophomore making that kind of play.
George against Jones White. He's going to give it top of the key to 25, Darren Wallace. George, near side corner, head fake, drives to the baseline, gets pushed back out. His pass stolen by Jones White.
Push it, push the issue. You got a 4-on-3.
White, he's going to pull up for three, near side wing, no. Rebound, spins. He somehow comes away, spins, puts it up, no. And Cade Smithart finishes the job for the Eagles as a timeout is called by the Bryan Hornets. An 11-point lead for Valonia.
That's a glass pass right there. Spence goes up, misses it off the glass. Clean assist. Boom, there you go. Speaking of clean.
It's Christmas time at Charlie's Corner. This winter, find the perfect gift with brand name options such as Duckhead, Lucky Brand, Oxford, Hey Dude, and more. Charlie's Corner is your one-stop shop for all your manly apparel needs. Don't forget to check out their sock collection and Razorback apparel when you stop by. Charlie's Corner, a proud supporter of Valonia Eagle Athletics.
You can't keep cheering about Brahms.
So basically what you're telling me, between Steve and your feet, Sam and Brahms, you fired them both.
I did.
So
well, not necessarily
not
fired.
Sam's not here.
Yeah,
well, then neither of them
left.
Are here.
Steve
Sam wasn't here last
by
night.
By choice.
Okay.
Sam got fired for the Brahms cheer.
So it's down to you, Connor, and I go back to a different state in 48 hours.
Yes. Well, I'm thinking about hiring Sam again once you leave.
Okay.
We'll see. Wow. We'll see if I can convince
turn
Steve
of a,
to come
oh,
back.
Oh, we're back.
Oh, we're back. Okay. Well, the Valonia Eagles lead by 11 here in the third quarter. 2 minutes, 3 seconds left to play. Drake, what do you expect to see from Valonia coming out of this timeout?
Basketball,
yeah.
In short, 11-point lead here. So I think, again, you come out from a defensive standpoint, I think you get a turnover here out of a Bryant timeout, you're in a really good shape, especially when you can keep running the fast break as well as Valonia has.
Quick three-point shot from Bryant, and they get it to go. That was Kaysen Robinson on the shot, hand in his face, it didn't matter.
Yep, it's Wallace and Robinson right now that are really making things happen for Bryant.
Spence with a good screen. Now it's Spence with it on the near side.
Man, I want to see Cannon Bartlett just elevate right here. He had a really nice shot on a jump stop earlier in the game. If he can emulate that, he's another really solid scoring option for the Eagles.
Deshaun Spence makes his man fall. Wants the ball back, they didn't get it to him. Passing lane closed up quickly. Good help defense.
Get an injury pass to Smith. Spence.
Wow.
One of those guys.
Spence on the baseline. Acrobatic finish. Couldn't get it to go. Still fighting for the steal. Instead, Bryant on the move.
If he can get a little bit further out there, get in front of the rim, in front of the backboard, put it off and in. That's good.
That three-point shot well short. It hit the net, which slowed it down enough to not go out of bounds. How about that?
Yeah.
Jones White. Hand off to Lawrence, Josh Lawrence.
How about that?
Give away to Cannon Bartlett.
Eagles with an 8-point lead. They're going to have a multi-possession lead going into the fourth quarter. Good spot to be in, but add to it right here. Take the last shot of the quarter. Going to the fourth, up 10, 11.
Spence to Bartlett on the near side now. Cannon Bartlett wants to drive left side. Give away to Spence. He's going to jab step, put it up and in from mid-range. And that's the shot you really want to see Spence develop over the course of his high school career.
Yeah.
If you get either a three-point shot or a mid-range shot down consistently, you're dangerous.
Jump over a defender, drop a 12-footer in there. Works for me.
Jump stop, floater up, no good. Left it too hard off the back iron. Three-point shot, however, will also rim out at the buzzer. Eagles with a 10-point lead heading into the fourth.
Yeah, you're looking at a much different dynamic if that goes in and Bryant has momentum going into the fourth. And speaking of being dynamic, Diamond Sponsors.
Wow. That almost sounds the same.
Yep. Dynamic Diamond. It's alliteration. Diamond sponsors include Centennial Bank, Linda Marie's. You have the platinum sponsors, Sims Electric, Roller, Gen Wealth, Filonia Therapy Services, Countryside Motor, Filonia Realty, HSA Engineering. Other platinum, Archer, Caldwell Banker, Reed's, right by where I live. Lane Family Dentistry as well. And around the table, Filonia Family Pharmacy, gold sponsors, silver sponsors, Harps, Simple Simons, Infinity Hair, Grant, go get a haircut.
I might.
Odd Insurance with Luke Gordon and Sue Shock Insurance. There you go. Big thanks to all the sponsors. I tell you, that list has just grown since I left. That's a great thing, seeing the community,
yes,
different facets of the community pour into Eagle Vision and what you guys do. Because I tell you what, for me living in Waco, it's great to be able to watch Filonia football, basketball, volleyball, track.
Yes.
Wherever I am. I love keeping up with it, and I wouldn't be able to if it wasn't for you guys. And I can tell you, coming from Texas, there are a lot of schools there that would be more than blessed to have a broadcast network where folks could watch them play.
Riley Sadler in the ballgame for the Eagles. Had a good impact there in the second quarter offensively. Aaron Brown is also in. Brown, ooh, finds Lawrence,
yeah,
on the back cut. Two quick points for the Eagles to start off this fourth quarter.
That is a beautiful dime from 6'6".
Drake, the Eagles won that third quarter. We'll see if they can keep that going here in the fourth.
Yeah, they did. Bryant had 17 points at halftime, only put up 9 in the third quarter. Only put up 18.
Robinson pulls up for three near side. Wing, and he got it to go. Great shot from Casey Robinson. He's cold-blooded. Speaking of cold-blooded, Sam Jansky is going to have cold blood when he keeps eating these Brahms shakes as he wants to revisit his contract. We will double your pay, Sam.
That's good. Yeah, a little body foul right there. And again, that's a foul that a lot of people aren't going to like. You saw a couple of those in the girls' game last night. And the reason you're not going to like that is you're thinking, oh, man, there wasn't a ton of contact, but you got to give the guy with the basketball space. The defender didn't do it. Good foul call.
Lovelace to inbound. He's got Sadler, and that's who we'll give it to. Riley Sadler working against Landon Newburn. He's going to give it up to Lawrence, who took that pass away from Brown. Lovelace driving along the right side, out of control, looks like.
Oh, they're going to call a foul.
Wow.
I think the baseline official wanted to call a travel, but the official nearest to us said foul, and I mean, I'm not going to complain. How about this? Talk about foul disparity in the first half. 10 at one point to Bryant's 4. Bryant has 4 right now. Filonia just 1. That was an emphasis at halftime.
Yes, it was. Sadler driving left side, give away to Jones White in the corner. White. He's got pull-up ability as that one is poked out of bounds by number 12, Landon Newburn.
Pull-up
good,
ability.
Good, what?
Pull-up ability.
Pull-up
I like
ability.
That was good. Yes.
You don't know if I'm talking about a jump shot or actual pull-up.
I think for Jones White, though, it's all about squirt ability. He's got that
spurt ability.
Another foul. This one's going to go against George, Gabe George. It's about the spurt ability, about the ability to get inside.
It's their bread and butter, if you will.
No, I mean, you're looking at Jones White with the basketball, without the basketball. He can cut without the ball. It's the spurt ability. I mean, he's here 1 second. He's in the next phase, 10 feet away the next second. He's like, well, where did he go? It's just that little quick spurt, and he's in a new spot.
You know, I'm this close to firing you as well, Drake.
With the basketball, it's spurt ability.
I'm this close.
He's in this spot. Boom, boom.
Jones White to
two dribbles
for the Eagles.
He's at the rim. Jones White, spurt ability. Another foul on Bryant. That's
wow.
Now 6 fouls. They've got 3 quick ones right here.
I didn't see what happened over there.
Well, it was, again, the spurt ability of Sadler.
I know a way to fix this. I know a good way to fix this,
in
actually.
In his effort to getting to the corner.
Let me reach this old soundboard over here, Drake.
Bryant's playing physical. Oh.
Riley Sadler gets away from his man for 3, no good. Rebound Spence, who puts it up and in. Deshaun Spence, the second chance points, have been there all afternoon.
That's just a better basketball player. I mean, what can you do about that? Try
Dave
to box
George
him out.
George pulls up for 3, and he got it to go.
It's George's first field goal of the game tonight for Bryant, and it pulls the Hornets with an 8.
Spence going to drive, wants to find Lawrence, who saves it in. Now Bryant on the fast break.
Oh, man.
Newburn driving, Eurostep up and in. Great finish from Newburn.
If you're Troy Campbell.
As Jones White was there defensively. Eagles.
Good time for a timeout.
Eagles are trying to match this pace. They need to slow down, and he does get the timeout.
I think the timeout came a little bit early. You wanted me to cross the timeline. Couldn't do it. But I say we get across.
Thank you for your business.
And we are back here. Timeout call by Coach Troy Campbell. I almost called him Jeremy Simon there.
Yeah, it's a new era here at Bologna basketball. The first person who can live fan feedback us, what spurtability, the significance of the word spurt, where it came from. If someone can tell us where it came from, they get a shout out. A little cameo on Eagle Vision today. It's a pointed.
Oh, I hope it's Sam that says it. That would be funny.
It's a pointed term. It's a pointed term. It comes from somewhere.
Riley Sadler handling the basketball for the Bologna Eagles as he crosses the half-court stripe. Sadler wants to drive along the left side, put it up and in. Great finish from Sadler. That's what you want coming out of the timeout if you're Coach Campbell.
That's good soup right there. Solid stuff from Sadler.
Sadler out defensively now against Landon Newburn. They get it inside. Spence pokes it away. Going to be saved in. Spence knocks that pass out of bounds. He's just denying the low post.
He's everywhere. Just when you think, oh, man, I can fake a pass and make one, which is usually the case, Spence just has an arm on the basketball.
Steve says Wi-Fi is working great. That is not where spurtability came
from. I think Steve, if it's past 2 o'clock, he should be off now, so he should be able to watch.
Lovelace hits the floor, whistle blows. They're going to call a foul against Lovelace. 5:45 left here in the fourth quarter. 42-34, Eagles with the lead over the visiting Bryan Hornets in the Eagles' nest. Gabe George gets the inbound, gives it away to number one. Now near side is Newburn. Newburn going to drive, float it up. It's going to rim out, rebound, Spence.
Deshaun Spence right there, solid stuff. Good defense from Bryant. Sadler finding his way across the timeline.
Jones-White, give back to Sadler. Sadler going to drive, float it up. Tough shot, but he gets it to go.
10-point game. Just like that, back to a 10-point lead. Nearing that 5-minute mark. Yeah, it's a good foul call right there. Going to go get Sadler. Just getting a little bit too quick up under the feet of the ball handler. But if you're Bologna, up by double digits at the 5-minute mark, it's where you can start kind of pacing your game. You don't want to play not to lose, but you can still pace the game.
Yeah, you know, before the timeout that we saw from Coach Campbell, that's sort of what happened. The Eagles lost that pace that they played with so well as Spence is on the fast break with Lawrence. Lawrence going to float it up. Spence got knocked back. He still gets the slam over defenders, though. Nakeshawn Spence says, you take away the alley-oop, that's fine. I'm putting you on a poster.
Carter Valance likes that.
Spirit coordinator, brother of the Ginger Ninja.
I don't have any
Robinson
words.
Driving, floats that one up. Tough finish. He got it to go.
He immediately turned around and looked at the referee. Flexed on the referee. Said, you can't do that. He's got a great point.
Jones-White. Dribbling to the right side, finds Sadler. Drake, take a look at the comments. Sadler floats it up and in. Great
so
finish by Sadler.
So pretty. Yeah, shout out Sam Jansky. We got to get him on this broadcast after he correctly labeled where spurtability comes from.
11 points from Sadler, 10 from Spence, and 9 from Jones-White, number 3.
You know what we haven't seen today?
What have we not seen today?
A held ball.
We have not.
Saw about 30 of them last night.
We did.
None today.
Well, you know, it's 1 o'clock, now 2 o'clock on a Tuesday.
Steve's
off.
You
don't really see those.
No, you don't.
I wonder if he'll make his way back to the booth at some point.
Hopefully so.
Lovelace gets an inside big-time slam from Darren Wallace. And that's going to.
Oh, my goodness. They're going to get a technical.
Wow.
They are going to get a technical, a little unsportsmanlike conduct against Bryant. And their coach is, on a scale of 1 to 10, not happy about that. He's saying, look, where we play, we don't call that. We get to celebrate dunks, and they're not going to let Bryant do it.
Wow.
That's so you can send Jones-White to the line here for a couple shots in possession.
He comes back.
Yeah,
he slammed the ball? What happened there?
I don't know. He gets the jam. Yeah, he slammed the ball. You're looking at the replay here on the monitor. Maybe he kicked it? I don't know.
It looked like it would have been an unintentional kick.
Maybe, but he definitely turned around and started screaming at somebody from Bologna. And on a scale of, again, on a scale of 1 to things you can do, that's not on there. They just took that one off last week.
That's true. It's a hit the road jack and yelling at players. You can't do those.
Can't say air ball either.
No, you can't.
Triple A. See that big AAA sportsmanship policy up there?
I do. Yeah. I do.
Malone, you got the, I think, Class 5A Sportsmanship Award in, like, 2011?
Something like that.
Yeah.
I think we've got one actually more recent than that now.
I should.
I think we got it a couple years ago.
Pretty good sports around here, you know? No
great
air ball.
Sports. Jones White handling the basketball is going to take to the left side and cross the half-court stripe. White in trouble, finds Spence. Gets it to Sadler. Sadler going to drive. Euro step up and in. Wow. Riley Sadler.
He's got a team-leading 13 points, and he has taken over this game offensively.
Off the bench.
Sadler, Spence, Jones, White in this game have been the trifecta.
Gabe George throws up that three-pointer. No good. Rebound Lovelace is going to slow it up.
Yeah, you're up 14 right here. Don't do anything crazy. Pace it. Take a minute off the clock right here. There's no shot clock today. There will be one of these days.
Jones White going to be fouled by number 12. That is Landon Newburn.
Yeah, utilize the lack thereof right here.
3 minutes, 24 seconds left in regulation.
Good counting.
Thank you.
Sadler's had some highlight reel stuff here.
You know, he comes off the bench and plays off the chain.
Speaking of off the chain, ground beef.
Exactly. That free throw up, no good. Off the back iron, rebound Bryant.
Free throws.
Lovelace got in the way of Kaysen Robinson.
And again, Kaysen Robinson just hears footsteps. It's the presence of Lovelace right there that makes him carry the basketball. Could have been a foul. Could have been a blocking foul
it
right there.
Have.
But Lovelace didn't, or Robinson didn't even get to Lovelace before he traveled.
Lovelace to inbound. Whistle blows.
It looks like this might. Yeah.
That's going to be on number one of the Bryant squad.
Oh.
Number two, one.
Yeah, so against Valonia.
Okay.
It's against Valonia. It's against Sadler. Sadler.
You know, it looked like all of the referees said, watch, this is about to be a foul, and then it was.
Yep.
They all looked ready to do
it. That was a good
call. That shot up and good. How about that? Bryant not
right.
leaving this ball game early.
Again, your play, you can't play not to lose here. Run your game.
Sadler.
Good screen.
Drive, kick out to Jones White. Could have shot it instead. He'll hesitate. Chew a little more clock.
Spence is just taking up space right there in a really good way.
Jones White, mid-range shot, no good. Rebound Bryant, but he's got to fight for it.
Uh-oh.
And he finds full court pass. Spence, the only
Deshaun
one with a chance.
Spence.
Great job to force the miss. Spence was right there ready for the head fake.
Again, Gabe George looked pretty uncomfortable on the offensive end. Happens again there, and they're going to call Jones White for a carry? When's the last time you saw that called? A carry? Jones White saying the same thing. He's saying, Mr. Sir, a carry? And the officials just kind of get a big smile, kind of chuckling a little bit. I don't know. It's been a long time.
Man.
I don't really call much of those anymore. I wonder what Chris Lee would say about that.
Robinson from the baseline couldn't get that floater to go over Spence. One of the tougher guys in this Bologna squad to float it over.
Yeah, definite air ball chance right here. That hurts my morale.
Now it's a 3-on-2 fast break. Bartlett getting back quickly. But that layup, still no good. Good defense by the Eagles off the fast break. That's going to be a travel as Bartlett rolled over with it.
I don't think Bartlett had possession of the basketball right there. And I think Bartlett's saying the same thing. He's saying, I didn't even have the ball. I was just trying to collect it.
It looked like the referee may have had a tough angle to see that.
Well, then don't call it.
Well, Drake, I'm not a referee.
That's a good point. I don't mean to be mad at you there.
That shot up and good. Kaysen Robinson trying to will his team back into the ball game.
Troy Campbell's got three timeouts here. Get it across the timeline. Call one of them.
Coach Campbell standing up. You know, looks like he may be ready for a timeout.
Maybe not.
But he sees something he likes here. Lawrence in the far side corner. Needs to get it away. Find Spence, who's left open. Spence, kick out to Sadler for three. No good.
Could have been a dagger.
Rebound, Bryant. That's a shot you like to see from Sadler, especially the way he's been playing today. As that three-point shot is up, no good. Rebound, Jones White.
Right off the back of the rim.
Eight-point ball game. Offense has come at a premium today, especially in that first half.
Yeah. Second half definitely been much more of an explosion for both teams.
That ball poked out of bounds by the Hornets. Looked like Kaysen Robinson was there looking to make a play, as he has often in this fourth quarter.
Man, this might be a good spot for a timeout. Just settle things down. Keep your guys ready. You got the ball in the corner right here. It's a tough place to inbound it. In soccer, great. Basketball, no bueno.
And a timeout called by Coach Campbell.
There you go. Great call there. I love that call. Speaking of great things.
D&N Construction has been a proud supporter of the Valonia Eagles as a locally owned and operated business since 2011. For any commercial, residential, and remodeling needs, be sure to call D&N Construction at 501-796-6316. And, as always, go Eagles!
And we are back here in the fourth quarter. Eagles hold on to an 8-point lead, Drake. Minute 23 left, and you've got to inbound the ball from underneath your own basket.
Yeah. Still not a great spot to be in the corner right there.
No.
But Coach Campbell had a second to draw something up, calm his guys down a little bit. Up by three possessions.
Jones White needs help. Bartlett gets it into him.
Crafty by Bartlett.
Jones White barely got back inbounds in time, but yeah, great job by Bartlett to find him. Sadler says, you reach, I teach, goes the opposite way.
He did say that.
He did.
I can read lips.
You can. You took a class in junior year.
Phonetics.
Jones White on the far side. Now it's Sadler. Bryant might be looking to foul,
but
now
they
got Sadler held up, who gets it away to Jones White. Now it's Lawrence, near side corner, head fake, 3-point shot up, and in.
That'll do it.
And Josh Lawrence.
That'll do it.
Is going to get a technical foul, it looks like.
Oh, my goodness.
He held up a 3-point sign like he's Carmelo Anthony, and they're going to team up.
You know what they say, though? I mean, there are kids here. You can't do that.
That's true.
There are kids here. You're going to hold up a 3-point. Next thing you know, these guys, it's a gateway.
You know, it's a touchy technical call there.
Celebrations in basketball are gateway calls. I mean, like one day you're holding up a 3-pointer.
Yeah.
The next day, you're going to jail.
That's true. You see it all the time. Jail.
You have to be an upstanding influence for the children of the gym today. Holding up a 3 after a 3-pointer is not doing that.
It's not okay. First free throw up. All around, no good on the free throw. On the technical free throw also. Robinson.
You see the Chiefs player last weekend that pointed and got the foul?
Yeah, no room. No room for
my
that.
My little sister started crying.
Wow, Lila.
Yep. You got to call that stuff.
That free throw will fall. It's a 10-point ball game with 51 seconds left.
Yeah.
We're going to get a timeout call by Brian.
Can't help but understand it. Kids hit it. He hits a dagger 3. You just got to kind of hold it to yourself.
Don't get excited.
Don't get excited. But one thing that we both get excited for.
As a Valonia alumni, I'm a proud supporter of Valonia Athletics. My name's Carter Archer, and I'm a realtor at Caldwell Banker serving Central Arkansas and surrounding areas. Growing up with a strong passion for the outdoors and realty, I fully understand the value of real estate. Standing behind honesty and hard work, I'm fully dedicated to assist you in your next investment. Go Eagles!
Ever tell you the story about Joe Nichols?
I don't think you did.
Yep. Kid hit a big, big time shot in a game, state title game. Hit
yes.
a 3-pointer, started celebrating, fell into addiction.
Wow.
Yep.
What kind of addiction?
Addiction, he was addicted to education.
Wow.
Spent a lot of, got buried in student loans.
That's
just
a
tried
tough
and
one.
Tried to get more and more degrees.
That 3-point shot, no good. Rebound, Spence, who got way up there, still fighting for it. Do we see it, Drake? Do we see it?
Technical foul.
Held ball.
Telling you, man, these guys, these officials, look, you can see it on the faces. They said, look, it is 2:15 on a Tuesday. I just want Thanksgiving to be here, man. I just want Thanksgiving to be here.
It's the Thanksgiving season, Drake.
So we're gonna put on a show today. And boy, have we seen one.
Yeah, but don't get too excited over it.
Hey, it's been even both ways. I love that.
Yeah, free throw line. Jumper is good. Gabe George.
Second field goal for George. Pretty solid one right there, putting points on the board. Brian's got a foul. Brian's got a foul if they want to win this game, but they might just fold.
Sadler still dribbling. Less than 30 seconds left. Jones White back to Sadler.
I think Brian's good with this result. I think they're good. They are. Yeah, they're content.
They'll keep it within 10.
The Eagles are going to hold Brian under 50 points today.
Wow.
Brian Coach is visibly upset here, but, I mean, this is just kind of what you asked for. Bryant
looking for the steal, and they do get it. Now they've got a fast break opportunity. That layup is up and good. That one they get to fall. And Drake, that's the end of the ball game. Eagles take this one 55-49. Big time win for Valonia. Both teams, you know, coming away with some people off of the football team. You know, it's not a normal regular season matchup, but it is one that you want to win and you need to win if you're the Eagles.
Yeah, great win by Valonia. I mean, you're playing a really good Bryant team. You hate to see the extracurriculars today. I mean, guys out there just making fools of themselves. But you know what? In the end, the Eagles pull away with the win, and that's all that matters at the end of the day. I think Coach Campbell is going to tighten up some of that stuff over there and make sure the unsportsmanlike conducts are at a minimum this season.
You're absolutely right, Drake. Couldn't agree more. You know, it's been nice to have you back somewhat.
It's been nice to be back somewhat.
Wow.
Yeah. Too bad I got a technical tonight.
You did.
They should have given one to you.
They should have. I got a little excited. I even threw up a three-point shot.
Nope, can't do that. Kids will watch this broadcast. Family-oriented.
55-49. Bryant Hornets early struggled to get shots to fall, and that was what did it for them this afternoon, not even tonight, this afternoon. It's still daytime, Drake.
Yeah, it is still daytime. What do you do with the rest of your day? You celebrate a big win. You go, you eat.
Absolutely.
You pregame Thanksgiving
you
with
go
the pregame
to
Thanksgiving meals. You know, you just have like your pregame meals to get to Thanksgiving.
Right.
You see Country Roads is blaring right now. The guys in the middle of the court right here are going to pray. That's good to see, you know. Valonia coming out and showing class in despite of what we just saw, in despite of the egregious things we saw, Valonia still staying true to their team culture. And great crowd today for 1 o'clock on a Tuesday afternoon. And man, fun being back. It was excited to see Valonia go out there and beat a 6A school like Bryant,
yes,
just a couple of years removed from a state title, with a couple of their best players still on the floor. Granted,
right,
some football guys. You still got a lot of talent was out there for Bryant tonight.
Absolutely, today. Drake. Hey, and with that, I think we'll go ahead and end this stream and be back for the V-Town Showdown. I think the girls will start that off against Sylvan Hills, if I'm not mistaken.
I'll be there.
Don't quote me. No, you won't. You'll be in Waco. Hey, I'm Grant McNew alongside Drake Toll and Connor Hudgens. We'll be back later on.